Hello, everyone. I am so excited today. I have with us Olivia Jaramillo. She is the House District 14 candidate for the Democratic Party, and I am really excited to introduce you to her. She is a veteran, and I'm learning more and more every day as I approach my own public service how much more I admire and respect those who have served in our armed forces. Anyway, I'm excited to introduce you to Olivia, so stick around. You don't want to miss this episode. Olivia, welcome.
Hi, Devin. Thank you very much for having me. I'm so excited to do this.
Well, we're thrilled, we're honored, we're grateful. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
What do you want to talk about today?
Well, you know, there's a lot of things I would love to talk about, however, I think one of the biggest things that we need to address here in Utah is population growth and a lot of things that come with it. You know, the middle class, I believe it's very much being impacted by this growth. And there's so many different angles that we can take on this, but I would like to discuss this with you today. What do you think?
Well, I really appreciate it. You know, population growth is essentially inevitable in Utah between in-migration, because this is a great place to live, and our pattern of having babies. Our population is going to grow. Managing that growth is a challenge, isn't it?
Absolutely. And you know, one of the reasons our state is becoming overpopulated, besides, like you mentioned, the ever-growing number of Utahns, is people who move from out of state because they just simply can't afford to live in the West Coast, specifically Devon. I'm sure you have seen that there's a lot of imports from Oregon, that we have people coming from California, and that creates more demand on homes, and more demand for homes means more homes that need to be constructed. More homes and demand means that they increase in price, that means they become unattainable for young families. And it's kind of a cycle that this population growth, we're sort of buying ourselves out of being able to afford a home, however small we want it to be or however big we want it to be.
What are some of the solutions that you think we should be implementing?
Well, I think one of the biggest things that I would like to see, and one of the things that I've done even in my district, in my campaigning, canvassing in House District 14, it's located in North Davis County, for those that don't know where it is. And it basically runs through the entirety of Syracuse, Utah, Clearfield, Utah, a little bit of Northern Layton. So I've addressed all three cities. One of the biggest things that I see here is that they're bedding communities. We need to start pumping in more commercial, more ability for the cities to be able to have their own income outside of just raising property taxes or anything like that. I believe that is going to be one of the biggest things that we can do, is enabling these cities to be self-sustainable and to be able to grow beyond just being a bedding community. And also, I think one of the biggest things that we've seen, and it sounds very progressive to say building new cities in Utah, however, I think that is one of the things that, it's not because Olivia is saying it, it's because it's one of those things that we're just going to see happen in the state of Utah. I believe it is.
Yeah. The building communities where people can afford to live is a challenge, and I appreciate you advocating for it. So, what are some of the other things that you would do to help make sure that our cities are livable and affordable?
Well, one of the things that we need to do is, from a legislature standpoint, I would like us to just address the issue of wages, and also of lowering not only taxes, but we need to really evaluate everything we are doing in terms of taxation. I think the more we can give breaks to the people, I know that sounds like a very populist thing to say. However, I think it is very important to address that, the cost of everyday needs, that we can afford them, any little tax break that we can find in there. That can enable, especially that middle class, to be able to grow. I'm sure you know, Devin, housing is expensive. You have things like expensive childcare, and then you have healthcare costs as well. That's another thing that I believe the legislature specifically, we can start addressing, and in a long-term process, start evaluating how much can we help in that department specifically in enabling people in receiving medical care.
I think your point about wages is incredibly important. I read a statistic today that there's nowhere in the country, literally nowhere, that someone who earns minimum wage could rent an apartment if they spent 100% of their income on rent. It's just a tragic observation. We need to do so much more about this issue. I'm so glad you're fighting the fight. Thank you for doing that. Olivia, before we wrap up, tell us, what is your superpower?
My superpower it kind of goes everywhere. I believe it's resiliency. It's fighting through adversity. That's really been what my life has been all about. Immigrating from Mexico, I've had to elbow my way into so many things. And I believe now I can use that superpower specifically to help people. And I want to help the people of Utah. And when I say people, Devin, I mean all people, not just Republicans or not just Democrats. I mean all the people of Utah. I believe that's my superpower.
Yeah, that's great. What a superpower. Well, Olivia, you're running for this important House seat, District 14. Tell us how people can learn about your campaign and how they can connect with you personally.
They can connect with me on oliviaforutah.com. It's really easy to remember, Olivia for Utah. You can just type it into Google. My Facebook, my Twitter, my Instagram, all of it is labeled under the same thing, Olivia for Utah. Just please go ahead and visit me. I would love to hear from you. And you know what, Devin? I do have so many people reaching out to me from all across the state, from here within my district, and they all have legitimate concerns, and I address every single one of them back. So please don't feel that I won't write back to you. I'll definitely reach back to you.
Oh, fantastic. Well, Olivia, thank you so much for being with us today. We wish you every success in helping to manage growth in Utah, especially to create affordable housing.
Thank you so very much, Devin. Good luck to you as well.
All righty. Let's be bold together.
Let's be bold.
I'm Devin Thorpe. For the last 8 years, I've been working full-time to eradicate extreme poverty, improve global health, and fight climate change. I've concluded that the best way for me to continue my work is to run for Congress to represent the people of Utah's 3rd District. In Utah, we have common shared values. Those things unite us. I believe passionately in our ability to come together, and I believe that working together, we can solve Utah's problems. I'm Devin Thorpe. I'm a Democrat. I'm running to represent the people of Utah's 3rd District.
I'm Devin Thorpe, a candidate for Congress, and I approve this message.